Zaczęło się od tego, że nasz właściciel...
It was a time of very big, I would say dramatic even changes in the Polish economy. Thanks to the economic and political transformation in Poland, it has begun to be possible to develop international presence of our company. As a first step, we thought about exporting. Foundation for the future development of exporting was laid by the German firm that joined our group together with the owner. Later, in the early 2000s, we bought a Scandinavian refrigerator company with a strong, well-recognized brand. As a next step, we started to develop our presence in Russia and on the Eastern markets through our German brand. I have to admit, it was all hit and miss in the beginning. We started exporting with help of our German subsidiary and later developed our direct export from headquarters. We still export a lot of products, not only to the countries that are relatively close geographically, like for example to the Balkans or post-Soviet countries, but also to Vietnam, Thailand, and even to Australia, which remains a big challenge as we do not know these markets well enough yet. At some point, we developed our strategy and decided to start acquiring companies on different European markets. We found out that it's much easier to distribute our products through distribution channels already developed by the acquired firms. It's still a complicated process though, but we do our best to use the bought brand to fill our production capacity. We plan to increase our global presence in the future, especially on the Eastern markets. This strategy stems mainly from the growing saturation of the European markets. It's getting more and more difficult for the companies like ours to build their market share. We are also aware of increased competition from the Chinese players. They are acquiring new companies in a very fast pace and bought two rival firms only last year. For our company, such processes take much more time and we wouldn't be able to reach our goals so quickly. I don't think we will ever focus on acquisitions only. We intend to stick to our international expansion model in the future. It seems to be working well for us, a mix of export and acquisitions, depending on the geographical distance and country's political and cultural conditions. Our presence in the Balkans, from the very beginning, was supported by an agent. He developed the brand's recognition in the region without any fixed costs on our side. I think it's a very convenient approach. It was a clever step to start from only one person developing our business there. The strategic question for the next years remains: when to move from this entry mode to acquisitions? We keep asking ourselves this question, and the answer will be a part of our strategy for the upcoming years. In 2007, we tried to build our own brand on the Italian market without having any customer base and, as it turned out, thorough knowledge on the market conditions. We hired an experienced manager to develop a new company and failed. It turned out that there are already very well-recognized brands present in this particular market, and existing connections among distributors play an important role. It was very difficult for a new brand to enter this market. We had to bear high structural costs without having any revenue, and in the end, we decided to shut down our Italian undertaking. It has taught us to revise this business model, opening subsidiary without having a customer base. At this moment, We don't operate in the Italian market and are starting to consider possibilities to enter this market in a different way again. In the late 1990s, we also took into consideration starting a greenfield project in Russia. We were very much interested in building a production site focusing on gas cookers. In the end, we decided against it. After initial research, we found out that we didn't have very profound knowledge of the market at the time, and the potential risks were high. We weren't entirely sure how to best operate in this market. At first, it was perceived as a controversial decision, but soon proved to be right when the Russian crisis began in 1998. At some point, we decided that in order to develop on the European markets, we need to start acquiring new companies. Trying to build a brand recognition in a new market has proved to be a difficult task, in which we sometimes failed and other times succeeded. But we've learned a lot from our previous experiences. Our latest acquisitions include a British and a French company. The British firm produces and designs studios for kitchen furniture with its own brand. The French company doesn't have its own brand, and adjustment of its business model to ours was and still is a difficult task. Thank you.